It's one of the most high-profile assassinations in United States history, and for decades there have been doubts about who killed civil rights leader Malcolm X. Now, more than half a century after his death, two men sentenced to life in prison have been exonerated by a New York judge.
Applause and relief as a dark chapter of America's history was corrected. Muhammad Aziz, jailed at the age of 28, now 83, and officially an innocent man.
I hope the same system that was responsible for this travesty of justice also takes responsibility for the immeasurable harm caused to me during the last 55 or 56 years.
He's one of three men convicted in 1966 for murdering Malcolm X, the civil rights activist and leader of religious and political group The Nation of Islam, was gunned down during a speech in a New York ballroom. Muhammad Aziz and Khalil Islam spent 20 years behind bars for the crime. Mr. Islam died in 2009.
The family suffered growing up with concerns of fear of people coming after us.
Lives and families ruined by misconduct at the very top of America's criminal justice system. In a fresh investigation sparked by the 2020 Netflix series Who Killed Malcolm X, the Manhattan District Attorney found the FBI and NYPD concealed documents and witness accounts.
That on orders from Director J. Edgar Hoover himself, the FBI ordered multiple witnesses not to tell police or prosecutors that they were, in fact, FBI informants.
The third man convicted and jailed, Thomas Hagen, confessed to the murder and said others helped him. Those people have never been brought to justice.
Those events were and are the result of a process that was corrupt to its core, one that was all too familiar to black people in 2021.
In the United States, Amelia Adams, 9 News.